For this evening's main events attraction, she works with main events tonight, Miss Gwen Summer. Miss Gwen Summer. And now, ladies and gentlemen, you've seen the lightweights, you've seen the heavyweights, you've seen the middleweights and the welterweights. Now let's make room for the big men. Let's welcome the heavyweight to the Magnificent Omni. This is a scheduled 8-round bout. From Brooklyn, New York, wearing the red trunks with the white trim, he weighs 225 pounds. His record, 8 wins, 6 losses, 2 by knockout. Let's welcome Sterling Benjamin. And his opponent, a member of the United States 1984 Olympic team. He's from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Wearing the white trunks with the blue trim. He weighs in at 218 pounds. The Super World Olympic Heavyweight Champion. Ladies and gentlemen, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the next World Heavyweight Champion.
The instructions by referee Ed Morgan, and we are ready for this heavyweight encounter scheduled for 8 rounds. Tyrell Biggs, 6'4¾", 218.5 pounds, checks in for this fight, his 5th as a professional. And Sterling Benjamin, 6'1½", 225 pounds. Benjamin, 32 years old, born in Trinidad, now living in Brooklyn, New York, a record of 8-6. And Tyrell Biggs out of Philadelphia, 24 years of age, and the record of 4-0. His debut against Mike Evans back in November of 1984, he went the distance 6 rounds. But since that time, he has registered a first-round knockout, a second-round knockout, and July 20th against Eddie Richardson, it was a third-round knockout.
And it was a very impressive performance that night for Tyrell Biggs against Eddie Richardson, who is no slouch. He just couldn't stand up to that hard left jab of Tyrell Biggs, who now begins to open up on Benjamin. Watch the left hand of Tyrell Biggs. He's a converted southpaw, means his left hand is his power hand. Anytime he hits you with the uppercut, the hook, or the jab, it is pulverized.
And it was last August 11th that Biggs defeated Francesco Damiani of Italy to win the gold in the super heavyweight classification. Biggs is big, 6'4¾", just under 6'5", 218.5 pounds. With that great hand speed, he'll work that stiff jab, setting up his opponent, who more than tipped the scales at 225 pounds. Earlier, Randy, we talked about at this stage of the careers of these fighters, how their opponents are selected very carefully. What was behind the selection of Sterling Benjamin?
Well, a good barometer is that in his very last fight, Sterling Benjamin went the distance with outstanding Canadian. He was in the Olympics, Willie DeWitt. He went 6 rounds with DeWitt. DeWitt hit him with his best shots, and stayed with him all the way. I think this will be a good barometer tonight.
And there is Benjamin with the rope-a-dope, using the ploy of Tyrell Biggs' favorite fighter, Muhammad Ali.
Now, only one of those shots got through. Now another one got through, and they were both left hands. Benjamin smartly keeping those hands up. big should be going to the body, because this guy looks like a Pillsbury Doughboy down there.
30 seconds left in this first round. Biggs's father was a tremendous fight fan and used to take Biggs to the Spectrum in Philadelphia as a child, watching all the fights. And there was one night he saw Muhammad Ali, Joe Frazier, close circuit, the first fight. That's when he said he wanted to become a boxer, just like Muhammad Ali. Final seconds of this first round, scheduled for 8.
Do you know what kills your muffler? Rust. Rust that can start on the inside and eat its way through. Now there's a muffler that helps stop this problem. The new Walker Advantage, with a revolutionary rust inhibitor, Absorbite, that actually absorbs internal moisture. The inside of this muffler was not protected with Absorbite. This muffler was. You can see the difference. The new Walker Advantage. It puts rust at a disadvantage.
Warranted at service outlets and auto parts stores where you see this sign.
Fasten your seatbelts, hold on to your eardrums, and get ready to take off on a heavy metal trip behind the Iron Curtain with Iron Maiden. Only $19.95. Call now. Use your credit card. Hard-driving concert performances of 4 hit songs, including Aces High and 2 Minutes to Midnight. Plus film clips of the world's heaviest heavy metal group on one Sony EP video cassette. Behind the Iron Curtain with Iron Maiden. Available from Sony in Beta Hi-Fi or VHS Hi-Fi. Call 1-800-USA-1000 now.
Second round action, heavyweights Tyrell Biggs from Philadelphia and Sterling Benjamin. You know, when Biggs saw Ali and Frazier fight, he was only 10 years old. And after that one, his father got him a heavy bag for the basement and saw the great enthusiasm that Biggs showed for boxing. And that's when he brought him to a local gym and he began his amateur career, a career in which Biggs won 108 fights and lost just 6. And went all the way to the gold medal in the 1984 Olympics.
And 2 of those 6 losses as an amateur came to the great Cuban Teofilo Stevenson.
Biggs, who got the great exposure, naturally as the super heavyweight, all the focus. Remember the fine commercials he appeared in, going for the gold, very popular. But then the bottom fell out for Tyrell Biggs. Question of whether he would be his worst enemy.
Well, he had been messing around with drugs, and he had been hiding it from his managers, Shelley Finkel and Lou Duva. But then they found out about it, and quite frankly, it's amazing that he went through the Olympics still messing with the drugs, winning the gold medal, and then finally, last January, he told Finkel and Duva, "I need help. Can you guys help me?" And they did. They got him the professional help he needed. He has cleaned his system out, cleaned his act up, and now I think he's on his way. Right hands like that, he's got to cut them out. That was an amateurish right hand.
One that you can get away with against Sterling Benjamin. And the crowd, after watching Pernell Whitaker moments ago, now getting a little anxious and impatient as Tyrell Biggs trying to figure out Sterling Benjamin. But the point made by Randy Gordon, Benjamin not very easy to get off his feet, going the distance in June with Willie DeWitt, who was the Canadian Olympic heavyweight silver medalist.
Although I was at ringside about 1 year ago when Sterling Benjamin fought in what talk show host David Letterman would have called a battle of the goopots against each other. It was Sterling Benjamin against James Broadaxe Broad. Broad hit him on the chin with one mighty left hand. Down and out he went.
Seconds left in the second round.
Oh, those rib roasters with the left hand by Biggs again. Just looking to soften up that flab around the middle.
Biggs says in his first 4 fights he's been able to use his speed, get by with just his speed alone to win. Final seconds.
Wallpaper that can match this?
Action below.
Sherwin-Williams.
Right now at Sherwin-Williams, save on hundreds of wall-covering patterns in stock, plus hundreds you can order, including the Gear Collection and Laura Ashley by Raintree. Prints for your kitchen or bath, classics for your dining room, colors for your kids' room, almost anything you can imagine now on sale.
That's it! Do you have a lamp department?
Sherwin-Williams. Spurgeon is next big league pitcher. And loves to serve fire-brewed strobes. See what I mean? That was his fastball. That was the curve. Look out. Wild pitch.
What was that?
Relief pitcher.
Strohs and Stroh Light for great taste and good times.
Third round action, Tyrell Biggs in the white trunks, Sterling Benjamin, 32-year-old fighter out of Brooklyn, New York, going against Philadelphia's Tyrell Biggs. This is scheduled for 8 rounds. Biggs in his first fight went 6, a decision over Mike Evans. Since that, he has gone a total of 6 rounds in his last 3 fights. And now it is Sterling Benjamin showing some aggressiveness, but Biggs turns it around. A flurry by Biggs as Benjamin covers up along the ropes. Benjamin then takes Biggs from behind the head.
Well, it has crossed the desk of Randy's rumors that Larry Holmes, should he defeat Michael Spinks in September, and I'm sure he will, when he goes to break Rocky Marciano's record, he'll tie him with the Spinks victory. He might take number 50. His opponent might be Tyrell Biggs.
Well, if you were Tyrell Biggs' manager, would you think that would be a good idea?
I'd say go for it. Look what Leon Spinks did against the great Muhammad Ali.
Well, in the end, look at what happened with Leon Spinks. I wonder if that early rise to prominence may have been a factor.
Well, Leon Spinks didn't have anybody like Lou Duva and Shelly Finkel around him. And also, Larry Holmes, as we have seen in the past, is bothered by outstanding left jabs. Call the truth, Williams. I still think, beat Larry Holmes. But Larry, the great champion he is, finished strong in that 15-round fight, as he will probably have to do against Tyrell Biggs. But it's a good test for Biggs.
All right, what do you think's going through Biggs' mind right now as he peers in at the 225-pound Sterling Benjamin, 32-year-old fighter who has a record of 8-6.
I think he's surprised that the guy has stood up through some of his best shots, but I think he's also happy that he's working the body very well, and he sees Benjamin slowing down. Benjamin is grunting when he's getting hit with those left hooks to the body.
And Benjamin now swelling around the left eye, just leaning on Biggs. This is nothing more than a good workout for Tyrell Biggs.
You know, Biggs should fight Larry Holmes. If he beats him, of course, he's probably the greatest upset in history. And if he loses to him, they say, so what? It's a kid with 7 fights, 6 fights, going against the great champion.
If you can see it that way. That's the way Carl the Truth Williams saw it, using it as a positive, going the distance. 10 seconds left in the round. As we pause for our local cable systems.
Foley's Blue Ribbon Sale is first class all the way. It's a flashy sale with the Canon T50 camera outfit at $259. How does a Sony Walkman radio cassette player for $79.95 sound? And here's a hot item, the Amana Microwave, now $218. Entertain this idea, a Toshiba VCR for just $319. The savings are real winners, so don't miss out. Shop Foley's Blue Ribbon Sale today.
The heart of Texas, Foley's.
The fact is, it is a crime to sell or pay for an unauthorized cable connection. The fact is, there's nothing neighborly about stealing cable. It causes reception problems and increases costs. The fact is, you can help reduce cable theft by reporting any unauthorized cable activity.
Thank you. round action. Heavyweight Tyrell Biggs, who won the gold medal in the super heavyweight classification.
Well, for the first three rounds, Tyrell Biggs has elected to stand in close with the pudgy but strong and crude Sterling Benjamin. Now Tyrell is using that long reach advantage of his. He's got a 33-inch Randy's reach right down the barrel of the jab, and he is using it. When he starts using that jab, right behind Larry Holmes and Paul Williams, it is outstanding.
And as Biggs doing some dancing on his toes, fourth round action, referee Ed Morgan, not much room in the ring.
Look how he tripled up on the jab. Only one of the punches landed, but that's the sign of a developing throw.
Some of the fans getting impatient, Randy. You feel that Tyrell Biggs could be doing any better than he is?
Yes, he should have been doing this earlier instead of just mixing it up right away with Benjamin. He should have been in the middle of the ring, allowing Benjamin to come in, and as he came in, landing the combinations, planting his feet, and getting off.
Midway in the fourth round, still hearing some boos. A great expectancy, Tyrell Biggs, but he has lived with this for a while, even through the Olympics.
He has heard the boo birds before, and he'll hear them some more, because he's not that one-punch knockout. A lot of the heavyweights really carry that one-punch knockout power. Tyrell doesn't. I think it will come in time, though, as he learns more and more leverage. That right hand he throws is very sloppy. Twice in a row, he got hammered there with right hand because his left hand is so far down by his waist. Except he has no respect at this point for Benjamin's punching power.
Feels as if he has nothing to worry about. Benjamin 8-6, that's his record, 2 knockouts. Only 14 fights as a pro. He's 32 years old. He works in New York as a plainclothes detective. Sure, he did some investigating about his opponent's style before stepping in the ring tonight. 20 seconds left in the fourth round.
Those body shots are beginning to bother Benjamin, because whenever he's getting hit there now, he's trying to cover up as soon as he can.
Biggs almost goes through the ropes in the final seconds of the fourth.
The great outdoors. We've got plenty of it here in Maine. One man, L.L. Bean, took our love of it and created some of the finest outdoor products. Clothing and footwear, durable enough for wilderness, yet attractive enough for town. In service, he'd send you a missing button 20 years later. And it's all in a catalog we'll send you free. Just call 1-800-228-1200-LLB for quality you might have thought long gone.
Hello, everybody. Gorilla Monsoon here along with Jesse the Body Ventura. Want to welcome everyone and invite everyone to a very special prime time this week, in which we'll see the $15,000 slam match between Andre the Giant, Big John Studd.
A lot of controversy still surrounding that body slam. Did Andre slam Studd? We'll find out.
Be sure and join us this week on Primetime for a special attraction.
The Slam Challenge on Primetime Wrestling at 8 Eastern on USA Tuesday.
Tyrell Biggs comes out to the middle of the ring to meet his heavy bag for the night, Sterling Benjamin. And Benjamin making Biggs work. A little question about the outcome of this one. Biggs in control and not really threatened or worried about Benjamin. And how would you assess Biggs right now as he steps in round number 5?
It's amazing because his left hand, his jab is world class, his hook needs some work on, his uppercut is approaching world class, but his right hand is still strictly from the amateurs. And I mean, not Olympic amateurs either. I'm talking Golden Gloves, Freeland, novice. There we see some Nice defensive ability from Biggs backing up. He should be hammering him over and over with that jab, just like that.
And Tyrell Biggs now opening up, dancing, throwing in the jab, looking for the uppercut.
Because he's a converted southpaw, I don't think Tyrell is especially comfortable when he lets the right hand go. One just straight below the belt. The right hand by Tyrell Biggs.
And Sterling Benjamin taking everything that Biggs has to offer.
Well, you can see how he took the best from Willie DeWitt. Which makes you think about James Broadax Broad's punching power. Sterling Benjamin told me it was a lucky punch. I said, Sterling, I was sitting there. There's nothing lucky about it. He held your chin out and hit you.
And with Biggs, Randy, you see Semple Styles as he gets in there with a right. You see a little of the Larry Holmes with the jab, a little of dancing in Muhammad Ali. And a great size, just under 6'5" and just under 220 pounds.
And he'll get a little bit bigger, too, as he works out a little bit more. Remember, the man is only 24 years old. He throws that left jab. Watch that jab of Tyrell Biggs. Jerry Cooney was another one. A one-arm fighter. He was a converted southpaw, but he can hit you with the jab, the hook, the uppercut. With that left hand, he pulverizes.
Straight left got in there by Biggs. And now it is Benjamin rolling on Biggs on the ropes.
The crowd getting on Biggs because they see a what looks to be an out-of-shape heavyweight in front of him, and they see an inability on Biggs' part to put him away, but they don't know like we do. The man went the distance with Willie DeWitt, and then he is semi-tough.
Final 10 seconds of the fifth round as Benjamin just content in laying on the ropes and taking what Biggs has to offer.
Another Strohs and a Stroh Light. So, with 30 seconds left, Monroe hits from the corner. But Goodrich comes right back with a 15-footer off the glass. Now, the Pearl gets the ball again with only 3 seconds left. 2-1.
You missed.
So did the Pearl.
Strohs and Stroh Light. Fire brewed for great taste and good times.
You can be funny.
I am funny.
Bud and Lou didn't always agree.
After Costello and Abbott.
To Abbott and Costello.
But when they did...
Who's on first?
I don't know!
Take me!
They were two of the funniest guys in America. Harvey Korman and Buddy Hackett are Bud and Lou, a USA premier event. At 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific, Monday.
Scheduled for 8. And Randy, so far as the fans get a little impatient with Tyrell Biggs, you have built up a defense and why he has been unable to put Sterling Benjamin down to the canvas, but just point blank, should he be knocking Sterling Benjamin down?
Okay, through the first 4 rounds or so, he was just setting Benjamin up. You don't just walk out and knock everybody out. And Biggs, of course, we pointed out, doesn't have that Joe Frazier kind of one-punch knockout power. But now the time has come. About now, if Biggs can't put him away, now is when I would start getting on him.
So here and wait and see if you start getting on.
What he's got to do is move the hand. He's got to throw that jab over and over again. He's got to work it. He's got to feint to the body, bring it upstairs. And he's got to shorten his right hand.
Benjamin, certainly, if you take a look at his face, has paid the price. Remaining in there, swelling around both eyes, and he now chases Biggs back to the ropes. Biggs tries to dance out of it
with no success at all. As he went one way, he ran into a left hand. He went the other way, he ran into a right hand. Biggs is never hurt by it, just off balance. And again, that crooked right hand of Biggs.
And the frustration there, Benjamin just sitting along the ropes. A warning from referee Ed Morgan to Tyrell Biggs.
Because Tyrell once grabbed onto the ropes and tried to pull his way in. Tyrell just shouldn't be so close. He should be a little bit further back giving himself room. He needs the leverage. He needs the room to punch. There was a good short right hand by Tyrell.
Remember, Biggs has gone a total of 6 rounds over the course of the last 5 months. This is the first fight he is scheduled for 8 rounds. Could he perhaps be feeling the effects of going this late into a fight, Randy?
Just maybe, but I don't see him hanging his mouth open, taking deep breaths. We'll have to watch. Meanwhile, the corner of Sterling Benjamin, Donald Hayes, his manager and trainer, keeps yelling at Benjamin, get off the ropes, get off the ropes. Their fighter isn't listening, and he's languishing, he's laying there, allowing Biggs to come in. I think it's a good place for Benjamin to be. He's not in the best of shape. He doesn't want to stand on those tired legs. And when he lays on the ropes like that, he's in a position to counterpunch Biggs with a sucker shot.
And I'm sure that's what he would say to his corner if he could right now. Closing seconds of the round.
If there is a computer in your future, then listen carefully. Urban General announces an exclusive TV offer of the Royal Alphatronic PC. This package includes a 320K single disk drive, CPM operating system, 64K memory, an easy-to-read amber screen, and the Peachtree software package, which includes PeachText for word processing and PeachCalc for financial records management. This is a limited credit card-only offer. Only 3,500 units will be sold nationwide at this amazing low price. Originally sold at $1,448, is available now through Urban General for $498, a $950 savings. Here's how to order your Royal Alphatronic PC for a 15-day free home trial.
To qualify for a free 15-day home trial, use your credit card and order now, 1-800-USA-1000, or send check or money order for $498 plus $15 shipping and handling to Royal PC, PO Box 2446, Atlanta, Georgia 30301.
So for the first time in his professional career, Tyrell Biggs enters round number 7. And I guess you'd say for the first time ever. Biggs, who has fought a combined 6 rounds over the last 5 months, knocking out his last 3 opponents. One in the first round, another in the second, and another in the third. And here he is, 7th round against Sterling Benjamin. Benjamin's swelling very badly now around the left eye.
The corner of Benjamin not happy with his performance. Before they were yelling at him, get off the ropes. Now they want him to start punching more. And there is not just swelling now, Allen, to that left eye. There is a cut that has just ripped open. Right hand, even though it's still amateurish, it is getting in occasionally. And that jab again and again, Biggs. That's what's swelling the features of Benjamin. What a jab it is.
Now it is getting in every time that Biggs throws it. The left jab, that long reach of Biggs. And Benjamin can do nothing to protect his face. He's trying, but it is cutting through.
And he's having trouble breathing. That mouthpiece he has in is one of those $2.50 mouthpieces. It's an upper and lower. The man can't breathe. Blood is now streaming from underneath the cut. From the cut under his left eye. He's in bad shape.
And Ed Morgan calling for the doctor to take a look. Stops the fight here in the 7th round.
Now in the state of Georgia, a doctor cannot stop the fight. He can recommend a fight be stopped. But unlike other states, he cannot stop it. He can tell a ref, I think you should stop it, but he cannot.
Well, if you're a referee, wouldn't you take that recommendation?
No question about it. But I've seen referees before not take the advice of the doctor. This time, he did.
And in the 7th round, Tyrell Biggs ends this fight. Of course, a booze from the crowd. They wanted to see it go more dramatically and earlier. But Sterling Benjamin surviving until the 7th round, and that lethal jab by Tyrell Biggs just too much for the face of Sterling Benjamin to bear. The swelling around the left eye, and then there in the seventh round, the cut was open, and that was it. A wise decision by the doctor and by referee Ed Morgan. In the seventh round, it was all Tyrell Biggs. So Biggs ups his record to 5-0, last four fights, ending the knockout route. And how about a report card for Tyrell Biggs, Randy Gordon?
He's fighting like a professional who has had five professional fights. What can I say? He's developing. The jab is truly world-class, but he needs work. And if they're talking about him fighting Larry Holmes, it's just got to be one big gamble. It's a fight I don't think he can win. I don't think he can look good in the fight. Tyrell Biggs should just keep developing, taking these kind of fights, taking another year, fighting perhaps another 10 fights or so.
And it is tonight, Tyrell Biggs, never in trouble. A seven-round workout on the heavy bag. And now let's go to the official time and ring announcer Joe Walker.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Ed Morgan stopped the fight after Sterling Benjamin sustained a severe cut under his eye. The time, 1 minute, 44 seconds of the seventh round. The winner by technical knockout, the next World Heavyweight Champion, Tyrell Biggs.
He's heard the boos before, but he's content with his victory. He knows it's a long road ahead, and he will take this one. A seventh round TKO over Sterling Benjamin. And Biggs remains undefeated at 5-0, and that is knockout number four. More boxing ahead from the Omni. It is USA's Friday Night Boxing.
Do you like to draw, sketch, or doodle? If you do, you'll want to enter this month's art contest with over $8,000 in prizes. I'm Paul Phillips, president of Art Instruction Schools. I'm frequently asked, do you really give five free art scholarships every month? Yes, we really do. And it's easy to enter this month's contest. We'll send you this free Draw Me art folder, and you draw any one of the interesting characters and mail it in. Each drawing is individually judged, and five winners are selected each month. The purpose of our contest is to find prospective students who appear to be properly motivated and have an appreciation and liking for art. Only amateurs are eligible. Complete rules are in the free Draw Me art folder. To get your free copy, just phone or write today.
Phone 1-800-USA-1000 or write to Art Contest, Box 49648, Atlanta, Georgia. Phone 1-800-USA-1000.
Tyrell Biggs with a victory over Sterling Benjamin. And now Tyrell is at ringside with Randy Gordon.
Well, the ring announcer called him the future, the next heavyweight champion of the world, and he just might be. But Tyrell Biggs, there's a plus and a minus, the good and the bad. The good, I think your left jab is strictly world-class, behind maybe only Larry Holmes' jab and Carl the Truth Williams' jab. The minus, the bad on the side of it, I think you crank up too much on that right hand.
Well, possibly. I do feel myself winging a little bit with the right hand. As you know, I'm still working on things and I'm learning, and I'm really improving everything. I think a lot had to do with his style, and I couldn't really set him up to really snap the right hand. So I was trying to land it the best way I could, and I thought winging it would be the best, better way as opposed to throwing it straight, because he had his hands directly over his face. I'm fighting really above my schedule right now. The competition of fighting is the only thing that I'm worried about. I think I'm a world-class fighter, and I'm not fighting world-class fighters. And that turns out to be a fight where the awkwardness and the overwhelming ability is not nothing I can do. I can't do anything about that.
This tough guy went six rounds with Willie DeWitt. Did you have it on your mind, I've got to knock this guy out?
No, I didn't. Actually, I wanted to just work on the things that I've been training for in the past 3 weeks. And if the knockout comes, good. But I'm really working and doing the things that I'm practicing on. I'm not going away from what I'm learning in the gym.
Okay, I want a truthful report card into those Friday Night Boxing truth cameras, Lou. Your report card, on his performance tonight?
I thought he looked good because I know what we're trying to put together with him now. Remember, you see out there, he can switch his style. He knows how to adjust. He was out there slugging with the guy. He was out there boxing with the guy. The guy was out there to survive, understand? I thought, and like you said about the right hand, you're right about the straight right hand. A couple times he could have thrown it, but more so he had to go around him. He had his hands up there. He was in to survive, but I got to give him on the scale.